Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So this is a second argument, another argument that opponents of gay marriage used to argue that gay marriage should not be allowed and should be illegal. And it kind of goes like this. It's like, okay, well, if we legalize gay marriage, doesn't that mean that, you know, something like bestiality or polygamy or incest marriage can possibly become legal? Because now we redefined the concept of marriage. What's to say that we won't redefine it again to include something like polygamy? That's the argument there. It's interesting that's the argument, because this argument clearly does not recognize the legal history of marriage. It's not like marriage has... It's not like, oh my gosh, we have this marriage concept and this is how it's always been defined from all the way from the beginning of history to now. It's never been changed. It's always been one man and one woman. That's been the entire history of the concept of marriage. And so now, if we redefine it as being like allowing the marriage to mean man and a man, or a woman and a woman, or a transgender person and a transgender person, now we've just tainted the concept of marriage. That's not true. That's so funny. Even if you look at like biblical times or ancient tribes, marriage was never defined like as this one basic concept that never changed. The concept of marriage has evolved a lot, even in America. For example, in I think it was all the colonies. I don't know. Maybe it was certain colonies. But I know this was definitely colonies like Rhode Island, Massachusetts, Maryland, and those things. It was actually illegal for a Catholic person to marry a Jewish person. It was illegal for a Protestant Christian to marry a Catholic Christian in some states. That was illegal. Is that still true today? Oh my gosh, no. Marriage has been redefined. Oh my gosh, marriage as a concept has been tainted. And up until 1960, it was illegal for a white person to marry a non-white person. Is that true now? Marriage has been redefined multiple times. In fact, marriage is not the same across the country. Marriage laws are very different from state by state, which is true, you know? So it's not like the legal definition of marriage has constantly changed. It's still changing. It's a constantly evolving thing. So are we tainting the concept of marriage? I don't know, because we've already done it multiple times. If that's the argument, that the gay marriage shouldn't be legalized, it's kind of odd if you consider the legal history of the concept of marriage. So that's one thing. And so now let's tackle this whole polygamy thing. So if we legalize gay marriage, that automatically makes us... That gives like the automatic obligation to consider polygamy. No, it doesn't. Polygamy and gay marriage are two separate things. Perhaps we can have a debate whether polygamy should be legal or not. That's a debate. That's possible, sure. But it doesn't mean that just because we have this debate about gay marriage, and once gay marriage becomes legalized, automatically we're going to start having this debate about polygamy. That's a separate debate. That debate can happen whether gay marriage is legalized or not. In fact, gay marriage can be illegal, and still maybe further down the road, maybe 10 years from now, it can be proven or it can be demonstrated that polygamy is beneficial for the whole society as a whole and is optimal for society. Maybe it can be shown that. I highly doubt it, because polygamy, as we know it, which is a man can marry multiple wives, is sexist. It infringes on women's rights. So because it harms more than half of the population of the entire society as a whole, polygamy would not be optimal. But okay, let's just imagine a time in 10 years from now, you know, we have this debate, and the winners of the debate are people who are arguing that polygamy is beneficial for the entire society, and therefore should be legal, because we're now, if we don't legalize polygamy, we are discriminating against religious people like Muslims who practice polygamy. Maybe that's a debate that's possible in the future. And maybe that's why, you know, polygamy becomes legal in America. What does gay marriage have anything to do with that? Anything. In fact, that debate can happen when gay marriage is still illegal. Polygamy could become legal before gay marriage. The two are two totally separate debates. So is bestiality. So is incest or any other thing. Incest was actually legal in some states in America in the past, but now it's not. We redefine marriage. Marriage is a constantly evolving concept, and it should be for the optimal, for the optimal course of society as a whole. Imagine if marriage wasn't changed. Imagine if it was still illegal for a Catholic to marry a Jew, or for a Protestant to marry a Catholic. It's changed. Has it been tainted? I would argue that it hasn't. I would argue that it's become a lot, the society as a whole has become a lot better because the concept has been redefined. So if that's the argument against gay marriage, it holds no merit when you consider the legal history of gay marriage.